Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Good evening. Pranawn da, croeso pawb. Welcome to our virtual open event for the engineering and automotive section. Just a few quick introductions. My name's Matt Collins. I'm the presenter, and the moderator who'll be able to take any questions from you is Kerry Hooper. Do you want to say a couple of words, Kerry?
Yep, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Kerry. I'm your moderator this evening. If you have any questions, please ask them. We can also keep them confidential, so don't be afraid to ask anything. No questions, a silly question. I'll keep it confidential if you ask me to.
Okay, so just on that note, if you can't see the question bar, if you hover with a mouse somewhere around the sort of top of the screen, there should be an option to show the question bar, and you can type any questions that you've got in there. I'm the head of creative and technical studies at the Newport campus. Kerry is the head of engineering at our Cross Keys campus, so we're both well equipped to give you plenty of advice on anything that you've got to ask. So what are we going to try and achieve this evening? We're going to tell you a little bit about the different courses that we offer. We're going to have a look at things like the entry requirements, what you're going to need to be getting in your GCSEs now this year in order to get in. We're also going to have a little look at sort of college life, what to expect, how it's different from school. And then we want to hear from you. We want to answer any questions that you've got, because that's the main aim of the evening, is to make sure that you go away with any questions that you have, and that you go away armed with all the information you need. So if there are people out there, then let us know you're here. Just type something into that question bar. It could just be a hello, could just be a thumbs up or something of that nature. Also, if you want to tell us anything about why you're here, if there's a particular course that you're interested in, you want to know about, then pop that in there as well, and we'll try and make sure that we cover everything. I'm going to go silent for a few seconds, let people do that, and then I'll see if any questions have appeared. So over to my moderator, Kerry. Has anybody put anything in there? Not to worry if not, but
yes, we've had a question about if motorsport's included, which it is. We're covering all the areas of engineering this evening, including automotive. So just hang in there, and we'll be going around to those in a short while.
Yeah, we'll certainly be covering motorsport. Little bit of a wait. It's not the first thing on the list, but we will get to you. So please be patient. Okay, just a little bit about the sort of general courses that we offer, and the sort of entry requirements that we're looking for. We offer courses from entry level up to level 3. We also offer some higher education courses, but if we focus on our entry up to level 3, generally. At entry level, we're not particularly looking for entry criteria, but as you go up through the levels, level 1, we'd be looking for people who are getting sort of at least E or above in their GCSEs, especially things like maths, English, science. At level 2, we're looking more at sort of D or above, and then definitely C or above once you get onto those level 3 courses, especially focus on your maths, that side of thing in engineering. If you want to do a level 3 course, B or above is really what you're aiming for in maths. So that's just sort of a general level about entry requirements. It's not quite as straightforward as that. Obviously, there's a lot of practical involved in a lot of the courses, so you won't necessarily jump in at a higher level if you need to build up your practical skills. So there's a variety of different courses, but we'll go through that as we go through the different areas. So I'm going to go through the areas that we offer one by one, and I'll have a little pause at the end of each one just to see if there are any questions. First one out there is electrical and electronic engineering. This is a big part of our Cross Keys provision. We also have it some electrical and electronics available down in Newport. We offer this at really at level 2 and level 3. To get onto the level 3 BTEC course, you know, you would be looking at getting those C or above and probably a B in your maths in order to get in there. The BTEC courses, just to explain a little bit about that, BTEC courses are fairly academic courses. There is an element of practical to them. We also offer craft courses in electrical and electronics, which is more your hands-on in the workshop. Both of them have elements of practical and theory, but the craft courses would be more erring towards the hands-on practical side, and the BTECs would be more towards the theory side. So we've got these at level 2 and level 3. It also plays a part in our level 1 course, which is a sort of a generic engineering where you do a bit of electronics, bit of mechanical. In Newport, you would also do a bit of welding. So it plays a part in that level 1, but the sort of normal entry level would be level 2 going into level 3. Mechanical engineering then, similar sort of thing. So mechanical engineering, we've got state-of-the-art mechanical workshops in both Cross Keys and in Newport. We've recently invested in brand new lathes. We've got state-of-the-art milling machines, bench areas. We've got computer-controlled machines. So in terms of mechanical engineering, what we're looking for is people who are really interested in going into that manufacturing sector. Manufacturing, maintenance, that side of mechanical engineering. Similar to electrical and electronics in that we've got sort of more craft courses, which are kind of hands-on in the workshop using lathes, milling machines. And then we've got the more academic BTEC courses, which are, they have more of an element of the sort of the principles, the science, the maths behind mechanical engineering. Again, we've got that at level 2 and 3, and it plays a part in that sort of multi-skilled level 1 course as well. Having mentioned those two, then it's a good opportunity to talk about our enhanced engineering program. This is a government sponsored scheme. We offer enhanced engineering programs in electrical and electronics and in mechanical. In this, you would do a BTEC level 3, plus you would do NVQ units, and there's a strong element of work placement involved in this as well. So we have strong links with a lot of employers in the area where you would do your work placement with those employers. So for a lot of people who are really looking to get into employment, apprenticeships, that kind of thing, this would be a really good route for you to go down. Entry criteria is similar to what we're looking for on the level 3 BTEC. So we, you know, really think about getting those C or above and really think about getting that B in maths in order to get onto this program. I'm going to pause just for a second there and see whether we've got any questions about those sort of general engineering, electrical, electronics, mechanical, and especially this enhanced engineering program.
Yes, we've got a really good question, and which I'm in the process of just putting an answer to as well. So someone's asked, talking to former students, is it correct that level 3 does not do as much hands-on as level 2?
As you go up through the levels, it will become more academic. It really depends on where you are in those level 3s. Again, we have the craft level 3 and we have the BTEC level 3. I would say that at a BTEC level 3, there is a lot more emphasis on the sort of science, the maths, the principles, materials, that side of things. The craft, there is still a fair bit of hands-on workshop based. Either route can give you UCAS points, either route can give you apprenticeship opportunities. So neither route really closes the door. So you really need to think about what it is you want out of this. Are you looking for something more hands-on when you choose those routes? But I would say that level three does generally become more academic than the level two.
And I think that's mainly Matt, isn't it? Because a lot of students go from level three BTEC to university. So yeah. Obviously there's a lot of underpinning knowledge needed there. Whereas somebody on a more craft-based route may be looking to work in a different environment in the workplace, in a less academic role potentially.
That's right. But again, don't think that anything closes doors for you. If you start down an academic route and you think, actually, what I'm looking for is an apprenticeship, that's fine. Also, if you're going down a craft route and you think, actually, no, I want to go on to university, speak to us and we can try to open those doors for you. Any further questions, Kerry, or?
I think we're okay at the moment to continue.
Yep. Okay. So our automotive technology, again, we've got two excellent workshop areas, one in Cross Keys and one in Newport. Again, working with state-of-the-art equipment, we've recently revamped our car fleet to a much more up-to-date car fleet. So you'd be working on up-to-date cars, working with the latest equipment. And this is for people who just love to tinker with cars and they're looking to get into that sort of vehicle maintenance, vehicle fitting, those sort of areas. Now, we have courses in automotive technology starting at entry level and going right up to level three. So you can really get from the absolute basics right down at sort of entry level, and we can take you all the way through up to level three. We've got strong links here as well with apprenticeship programs. So a lot of people start at sort of those entry levels as they work up and they find themselves a placement with an apprentice. You can switch to an apprenticeship program. So it's a really strong part of our offer at both Cross Keys and at Newport. So definitely it's something well worth considering. That you'll notice the picture of the motorbike there. So we've got bikes. I think it's part-time with the motorbikes, but we do offer a motorbike maintenance course as well in Cross Keys. So good range of things in the automotive sector. Have we got any questions about that, Kerry? Or
we're okay at the moment. I just think it's worth obviously mentioning our electric vehicles as well, Dave.
Yes. So when I say we're upgrading our fleet again, we're looking to move into electric vehicles and that side of things. So there's a lot of new technology coming into the automotive sector. It's probably one of the fastest changing sectors in engineering at the moment, and we are without doubt keeping abreast of that and upgrading our fleet and with electric vehicles.
We've had a question there about our bikes course as well, which I'll answer because it comes under me. So yes, we do have some motorcycle courses. The course that is specifically just for bikes is a part-time course at the moment, but some motorcycle content is also covered on our general motor vehicle courses too.
Okay, I'll push on there. We definitely had a question about this. So we offer courses in aeronautical and in motorsport at our Blaenau Gwent Learning Zone in Ebbw Vale. And yes, you do get to work on that plane and that racing car. So it's this is a very sought after two very sought after courses and one of our really big growth areas in engineering. So these are offered at level three. They're BTEC level three courses. Again, we're looking for students. We're really looking for students who are really enthusiastic about this kind of thing, but we want those sort of GCSE, C or above, B in maths to get onto these courses. But there's excellent routes from these into university. Swansea do an excellent course in degree course in motorsport engineering. The University of South Wales have got all sorts of aerospace opportunities. So there are, you know, really good routes from here into higher education and into industry as well. So any questions about those, Kerry?
None at the moment, but I know we do have somebody who specifically has asked about about our courses there. So I'll just give them time to type, and if I need to, I'll come back in with that question shortly.
Okay, I'll move on, but feel free to ask questions about things that have gone before. That's fine. So fabrication and welding, another really strong sector. We've got this is at our Newport campus. We've got an excellent fabrication and welding workshop. It's busy day and night. It's one of our busiest workshops that we've got in Newport, and you'll have a go at all sorts of different types of welding. Again, we offer this as part of our level one, which is a generic engineering course. You would do welding and a bit of mechanical engineering, as well as a bit of electronics, but really the entry level here is level two. So we've got a level two course and we've got a level three in fabrication and welding full time as well. So we're looking for people with that sort of D or above in maths, English and science, plus at least one other to get onto this course. But again, it's a really good hands-on course. It'll give you excellent links with apprenticeships and employment as well in this area. And then the other area that we've got is vehicle body repairs. So this is linked to our automotive area. It's offered in our Newport campus. We've got a vehicle body repair shop where they sort of look at repairing accident cars that have been involved in accidents, that kind of thing. And we have a paint shop where they do resprays, touching up, that kind of thing. So it's a course that we have strong links with apprenticeships. We've got level one up to level three in this area. So again, you'd be working with state-of-the-art equipment in an excellent area with strong links with industry. Okay, did we get any questions about that motorsport after, Kerry?
I've got a question from, so I think this is in relation to the motorsport, is asking if it's in Ebervale, which yes it is. That's the only campus that we deliver motorsport and aeronautical on. So I'll just respond to that. And then we've got another question about the electrical engineering course, and it asks, is there a way they can do a full-time course as well as being in the rugby academy? So all of our courses, we try and be flexible as we can around the rugby academy. It's been a little bit more difficult this year with coronavirus because of the way that we can't swap and move people around classes in the way that we usually would. But overall, yes, there's usually a way you can do your full-time course and be in the academy, with the exception of the EAPS course, which is particularly difficult because there are so many hours on there.
Yeah, and on that note about the coronavirus, all things being equal, if you're applying for a course for next year, then hopefully that will be all behind us by then. And so the links with the Rugby Academy will be right back on board. So we do encourage that kind of thing, that people get involved in the whole of the college life. And on that note, we'll have a little discussion about college life. So it is a very different sort of environment to school. And if you come from school, you will notice that it is very different. We've got lots of extracurricular activities, things like the sports teams, that kind of thing. We've got lots of clubs. We've got facilities on site. We've got dining facilities. We've got the cafe area. And we do really encourage students who come to our college to really embrace this side of the college and to get involved in all aspects of the college life, and not just the course that they're doing. We like to think that we develop the whole person and not just their vocational area. In terms of what you need to do in order to prepare for college, There are obvious things that we will provide them, but you are expected to turn up ready for work in an engineering environment. So there are things like PPE, things like overalls and boots and that kind of thing. Be prepared to have work experience, to be going on work placements. Also, things like engineering are, it involves an element of math, science, that sort of thing. So turning up with things like pens and paper, electronic calculators, that kind of thing is essential. But the main thing that we want is a really positive attitude. If you are keen about engineering and you have a really positive attitude and you want to learn more about engineering, we want you to come to us. That's basically where we're at. And we will find a course that's suitable for you, and we will find a way to give you what you want. If you have that positive attitude, that's what we really want you to bring to us.